सो हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 247। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड इन दिस सेशन गाइस वी विल एज यूजुअली डिस्कस पीआईबी न्यूज फ्रॉम द प्रेस इंफॉर्मेशन ब्यूरो ऑफ आवर कंट्री। ओके एंड दिस सेशन गाइस इज हेल्पफुल फॉर वेरियस गवर्नमेंट एग्जाम स्पेशली फॉर द ईएसआई सेक्शन ऑफ आरबीआई ग्रेड बी। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन गाइस, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन इफ यू आर न्यू हियर डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन एंड ऑल्सो यू कैन जॉइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप फॉर डेली क्विजेस and updated information about the daily sessions and also iska jo link hai that you will get in the description and that is a brief information about me. I have done bsc physics honors from Delhi University and also have cleared various government exams and if you want to ask any question related to your exam then you can follow me on Instagram. This is my Instagram id. Okay, so let's begin with the very first question, which is again about a loan, one more loan that has been given by Asian Development Bank. So in the yesterday session we have discussed about a loan that is being given to the state of Meghalaya worth 132.8 million dollar and now there is one more loan that has been provided by the Asian Development Bank. So the question is, ADB and Government of India has signed a loan agreement worth 50 million dollars to boost the digital platforms for public finance reforms. So for which state this agreement has been signed? So guys, this agreement has been signed with for the West Bengal. Okay, this agreement between the Government of India and Asian Development Bank has been signed for the West Bengal, and this is to boost the West Bengal's digital platforms for public finance reforms. जो public finance है उसके अंदर reforms लाने के लिए जो digital platforms हैं उनको boost करने के लिए this loan has been sanctioned for the Government of West Bengal. Okay. And that's it. इसमें आपको इससे ज्यादा और कुछ पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं है. Just remember, $50 million loan will be given to the government of West Bengal for boosting their digital platform so that they can reform, they can reform their public finance. Okay, so that's it. This therefore the correct answer is what? Option B, West Bengal. Okay, and Asian Development Bank, we all know guys, it is headquartered in Manila, which is in Philippines, and also Masatsugu Asakawa is the current president of Asian Development Bank. And talking about West Bengal, so recently they have launched Pathshri Abhiyan. They have launched Pathshri Abhiyan for road repairing. They have launched Karma Sathi Prakalpa scheme. They have launched Karma Sathi Prakalpa scheme for giving soft loans to the youth. They have launched Karmo Bhumi portal. They have launched Karmo Bhumi, which is a portal to help the IT professionals in getting their jobs, and there are various other very important scheme from the West Bengal, like we have Prochesta, we have Sabuj Sathi, we have Kanyashri Prakalpa, that's very important, we have Swasthya Sathi, all right, and we have one more, Sabla. So these are some government important government scheme from the government of West Bengal. And in West Bengal, and of course recently in the campus of CMERI, Central Mechanical Engineering Research Institute in Durgapur, world's largest solar tree was inaugurated. Okay, and talking more about West Bengal, so you will find Sundarban National Park there, you will find Gorumara National Park there, you will find Baksa National Park there, which is also a tiger reserve. Of course you will find Jaldapara Wildlife Sanctuary there. Okay, so these are some wildlife sanctuary and national park that you will find in West Bengal. And also there are some traditional dances that we find in West Bengal, like for example we have chhau, we have gombhir, we have brita. So these are some traditional dances of West Bengal. Okay, and here the correct answer is what? Option B, West Bengal. And now guys, let's move on to the question number 2. So you have to consider the following statements regarding Adi Mahotsav. So there is a Mahotsav that is being organized by the Ministry of Tribal Affairs in association with TRIFED. Okay, TRIFED और मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स दोनों मिलकर आदि महोत्सव ऑर्गेनाइज करते हैं. सो यू हैव टू कंसीडर दी स्टेटमेंट्स अबाउट दिस महोत्सव एंड यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट्स. ओके, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस आदि महोत्सव. सो रिसेंटली द फर्स्ट एवर वर्चुअल आदि महोत्सव. इससे पहले वर्चुअल नहीं था, सो बिकॉज ऑफ पैंडमिक एवरीथिंग इज गोइंग वर्चुअल. सो फर्स्ट एवर वर्चुअल आदि महोत्सव हैज बीन लॉन्च बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स विद अ फोकस ऑन मध्य प्रदेश. ओके, this time the focus state is what? Madhya Pradesh, and the next focus state would be Gujarat followed by West Bengal. Currently the focus state is what? Madhya Pradesh, and after that the focus state will be West Bengal, Gujarat, and then we will have West Bengal. Okay. And talking more about this Mahotsav, so it is a national tribal festival that is a joint initiative of Ministry of Tribal Affairs and TRIFED, as I told you. And it was first launched in the year 2017, which means the first edition of Adi Mahotsav was organized in the year 2017. And since then, it is being organized annually. And last year, in the year 2019, it was organized in New Delhi. Okay. And what is the basic objective of organizing this festival, organizing the Mahotsav? So the basic objective, guys, of Government of India behind this Adi Mahotsav is to familiarize the people, familiarize the people with the rich and diverse craft, culture and heritage of the tribal communities in our country. हमारे देश में जो tribal communities हैं, उनका जो rich culture है, heritage है, उसको लोगों से familiar कराने के लिए this Adi Mahotsav has been organized by the Government of India through the Ministry of Tribal Affairs, which is headed by Arjun Munda. Okay. And this year, there will be a 10-day event, and it will be, as I told you, it will be organized in a virtual mode at Tribes India e-marketplace. Okay, so this you have to remember, it will be organized virtual on Tribes India e-marketplace. So there is a e-marketplace for tribal products, which is known as Tribes India e-marketplace. So this virtual event will be organized on this e-marketplace only. Okay, so that is about this news. Now let's come back to the question. We have to identify the correct statement. So the first edition was held in 2016. So is that 2016, guys? No, that's 2017. Okay. And it is a joint initiative of Ministry of Tribal Affairs and NAFED. Yes, it is an initiative of Ministry of Tribal Affairs, but not with NAFED. It is with TRIFED. Okay, which means this statement, guys, is also incorrect. And this year the focus state is what? Madhya Pradesh. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And then the focus state will be Gujarat and West Bengal. Okay. So therefore, we have to identify the correct statements, which means option C, only 3 will be the correct answer. And now, guys, let's move on to the question number 3. So again, you have to consider some statements regarding QS Asia University Rankings. So QS has launched the Asia University Rankings 2021. And remember, this is not, we are not talking about the World University Rankings. This is Asia University Rankings 2021. And you have to identify the incorrect statements among these 3. Okay. So let's talk about the Asia University Rankings. So as we all know, QS has released this Asia University Rankings 2021, and total 650 institutions were ranked from the 18 different locations. Total 650 institutions ki ranking ki gayi hai from the 18 different locations, and out of these 650 universities, 107 were from India. Okay, 107 institutions were from India, and the total number of parameters on which this rankings is based is how much? 11. So you just have to remember the number of parameters. Don't mug up the name of all the parameters. Just remember that there are 11 parameters on which this university rankings is based. Okay. And talking about the three top institutes. So number one, it is National University of Singapore, which is of course located in Singapore. Then we have Tsinghua University from China, and then at position 3, there is one more university from Singapore, which is known as Nanyang Technological University. Alright. And talking about the Indian Institute, about the rankings of Indian Institutes. So, out of these 107 institutes, only 8 institutes made it to the top 100. Top 100 mein keval 8 institutes the, and which are these? Or in 8 mein se bhi mostly kaun hai? IIT. We have IIT Bombay, Delhi, Madras, Kharagpur, Kanpur. Okay. In 8 में से 5 जो है वो IIT है, then we have University of Delhi, JNU and IISc Bangalore. Okay, so there are only 8 institutes from India in the top 100 in this ranking. Okay, so that's it about this Asia University rankings. Now we have to find the incorrect statements now. So total 650 institutions were selected from rankings. Yes, this is absolutely correct. 650 institutions were there. Tsinghua University of China has topped the ranking. No, that's not Tsinghua University of China which has topped it. It is ranked at number 2. 10 institutes from India were among top 100 institutes of Asia. No, it is not 10. Only 8 institutes from India were in the top 100 in this ranking. So this statement is also incorrect. And we have to find the incorrect one. Therefore, option B, only 2 and 3 will be the correct answer. And now let's move on to question number 4 and 5, which is based on the World Malaria Report that has been launched by World Health Organization. World Malaria Report 2020 launched by WHO. And the question number 4 and 5, both are based on it. So let's talk about the report first. So these are some key highlights from the report, and these are the global data. Talking about the global data, so globally there were 229 million malaria cases in the year 2019 as compared to 238 million in 2000. 2000 में 238 मिलियन थे, जो कि कम होकर 2019 में 229 मिलियन हो चुके हैं. मलेरिया केसेस पर 1000 पॉपुलेशन एट रिस्क, ठीक है, मलेरिया केसेस पर 1000 पॉपुलेशन एट रिस्क हैज आल्सो बीन रिड्यूस्ड फ्रॉम 18 2000 टू 57 इन 2019, जो कि 2000 में 80 था, जो कि घट के कितना हो गया है, 57 हो गया है 2019 में मलेरिया केसेस पर 1000 पॉपुलेशन एट रिस्क. ओके, देन बिटवीन 2000 एंड 2015 द डिक्लाइनिंग रेट ऑफ मलेरिया was 27%, while between 2015 and 19 there was very less declining rate of just 2%. Okay, the declining rate between 2015 and 19 was just 2%, while it is a huge declining rate between 2000 and 2015, that was 27%. Okay, and 29 countries are there which accounted for 95% ऑफ मलेरिया केसेस वर्ल्ड वाइड. पूरी दुनिया में जितने भी मलेरिया केसेस है उसके 95% जो है वो केवल 29 कंट्रीज में ही है. ओके, सो देर आर वेरियस कंट्रीज विच आर द हाई बर्डन नेशंस इफ विद रिस्पेक्ट टू मलेरिया. एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट रीजन, तो अफ्रीकन रीजन अकाउंटेड फॉर 94% मलेरिया केसेस ग्लोबली, विच मीन्स द हाइएस्ट बर्डन ऑफ मलेरिया इज इन द अफ्रीकन कॉन्टिनेंट. And Southeast Asia region accounted for only 3% of malaria cases globally, from where we belong, from where India belong. जहाँ से Southeast Asia region से India belong करता है WHO के, so वहाँ से केवल 3% cases हैं malaria cases के. And in this region, malaria cases reduced by 73% from 2000 to 2019. Okay, 2000 से लेके 2019 के बीच में बहुत बड़ा गिरावट आया है in the number of malaria cases. That is how much, 73%. Okay. And since 2015, European region has been free of malaria. 2015 के बाद से European region में कोई भी malaria का case नहीं है. Okay. And talking about malarial deaths now. So guys, globally, deaths due to malaria has been reduced in the period of 2000 to 2019 from 736,000 in the year 2000 to 409,000 in the year 2019. Still, it's a very big number, but yes, we are on a progressive way. We are improving. Okay. 2000 में 736,000 मौतें हुई थी मलेरिया की वजह से, जो कि घट के 2019 में हो गई 409,000. देन मलेरिया मोर्टेलिटी रेट. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस मलेरिया मोर्टेलिटी रेट? इट इज डेथ्स पर 1 लाख पॉपुलेशन एट रिस्क. ओके, हर 1 लाख पॉपुलेशन पे जो मलेरिया की वजह से डेथ होती है उसको बोलते हैं मलेरिया मोर्टेलिटी रेट. ओके, एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट मलेरिया मोर्टेलिटी रेट, सो इट ऑल्सो हैज बीन रिड्यूस फ्रॉम 25 इन 2000 to 12 in 2015 and to 10 in 2019, which means between 2015 and 19 there is a very less reduction in the malaria mortality rate. Okay, and about 95% of malaria deaths were only in the 31 countries. So there are some countries which are highly impacted by malaria. And now talking about guys India specific data, so India is the biggest contributor in the reduction in the number of malaria cases in the Southeast Asia region. In 2000, there were 20 million cases in India with respect to malaria, while which has reduced to 5.6 million in the year 2019. 2000 में 20 million cases थे malaria के सिर्फ India में, जो कि घट के 5.6 million हो गए हैं 2019 में, and there is a percentage drop of 71.8%. Okay, that's a huge drop. And but despite this, remember one thing, that India accounted for about 86% of the total deaths in the WHO Southeast Asia region. जो WHO का Southeast Asia region है, उसमें India की तरफ से जो total malarial deaths है, उसमें India का जो contribution है, that is 86%. But there is a good news also. This 86% is after the percentage drop of 73.9% in the malarial deaths in India. Malaria की जो death है, वो India में कम हो रही है, but yes. In the South, ये भी एक बहुत बड़ा fact है that in the Southeast Asia region, India is the biggest contributor of malarial deaths, that is whooping 86%, alright? And in India, 5 states which are Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Meghalaya and Madhya Pradesh accounted for approximately half of the malarial cases, and around 2/3 of the malarial deaths were also reported from these states, okay? So these are some India specific data. Remember this guys, these two points are very important, 1 and 2. And now WHO has released an initiative which is known as high burden to high impact फॉर 11 हाई मलेरिया बर्डन कंट्रीज इंक्लूडिंग अवर प्यारा भारत। हमारे देश को मिला के 11 ऐसे हाई मलेरिया बर्डन कंट्रीज है जहां पे ये इनिशिएटिव लॉन्च किया है WHO ने, जिसका नाम है हाई बर्डन टू हाई इंपैक्ट। एंड इन इंडिया देयर आर 4 स्टेट्स वेयर दिस इनिशिएटिव हैज ऑलरेडी बीन इंप्लीमेंटेड, विच इज मध्य प्रदेश, वेस्ट बंगाल, छत्तीसगढ़ एंड झारखंड। ऑलराइट, सो दिस वाज अबाउट दिस रिपोर्ट। नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 and 5। सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 इज व्हाट, विच इनिशिएटिव हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय WHO इन 11 हाई मलेरिया बर्डन कंट्रीज इंक्लूडिंग इंडिया टू कंट्रोल मलेरिया। So guys, this initiative, as we have discussed, I hope you can easily answer it now. It's option A, high burden to high impact. And question number 5, consider the following statements regarding WHO malaria report and you have to identify the correct statements now. So malaria mortality rate has been reduced from 25 in 2000 to 10 in 2019. Yes, this is absolutely correct. 25 in 2000 to 12 in 2015 and to 10 in 2019. India accounted for about 86% of total deaths in WHO Southeast Asia region. Yes, this is also correct. And there were 229 million cases of malaria in 2019 globally. So this is also correct, which means all the statements are absolutely correct here. Option E, all are correct, will be the correct answer. Okay. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope the session is clear and all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain Monday ke session mein. Goodbye, take care and God bless.